You have gas, brake, tilt left and right to tilt forward and backwards. And then they have a spring button where you can do like a bunny hop. But the physics in that definitely need work. It definitely needs to be lightened. It's a little heavy. It runs a little slow.
Oh, yeah, you don't want that. These games, you have to have like the full control and animation for it to be good.
Yeah, and it needs to be smoother just so you can flow. I mean, you know.
Yeah. Cool, man. Any other ones, Dor?
The only last thing I want to say is thank you to Sean. My UI frigging rocks. By far the most stable thing I've ever put on my phone. A close second, Liberty ASOP, AOSP. AOSP ROM Gingerbread. The one feature I gotta say in my UI I thoroughly like. Back on episode two or three, I kind of lied a little bit. I was misinformed about holding down the back arrow button to kill apps. In my UI, there's a setting you can put where if you hold that button down for more than 2 seconds, whatever app you're in will get killed. So if you have an app that doesn't have an exit button, now it does. It just
Nice.
doesn't know it.
Wow.
Yeah, no.
MIUI.
Another
Yeah.
everyone always asks about screenshots. I don't know if it should be the same for yours, but like if you hold the menu and your volume rocker down, it'll just take a screenshot. So you don't need an app for it or anything.
Sweet. Yeah, I remember Eric was taking
Well,
screenshots on his phone, but he couldn't figure out how he was doing it.
you
know, he just needs my UI. And so many features, can't go into it. I can't go into it.
Yeah, it's
Too many.
so customizable.
Really?
Yeah.
A anybody who reads the reviews, I know, like for mine, the Droid Incredible, a lot of people are like, oh, it looks like the iPhone. It's so not the iPhone. Trust me. You can change everything.
Really?
It's not, it's nothing. That's what scared me off that ROM for months. And then I just was
Yeah.
like, oh, I'll give it a shot. And then, I mean, it's just,
So don't trust the reviews.
no.
You said it's
Right.
available for Evo 3G or 4G too?
Yeah, I
Oh, it's
believe so,
available
yeah.
for a lot. If you go to miui.us, oh, a lot.
Now, I'll say what it appears like what this originated from was I'm in China. I have a couple million devices that look like iPhones that I want to sell. I developed this Android interface that l is iPhone-esque. And that was where it looks like it might have started. Oh, it's grown. Oh, it has grown so much more than that. The other stupid feature that I just cannot live without now, I pull down my notifications menu, and on the bottom, I have two big buttons, notifications and toggles. I hit toggles, and right there, I have 16 different toggles. I can quickly turn on flight mode, reboot, shut down, rotation lock, Bluetooth, GPS, lock the device, Wi-Fi, data, sound, ringtone, privacy mode. Privacy mode. Too cool. I'll stop
Awesomeness.
talking now.
That's cool. No, I might give that one a look, actually. You guys have anything else before we do emails? And then we could talk about stuff after emails if you want to.
I'm good.
All right. Tim, anything?
Nope.
All right. Okay. Let's do
I'll
some
just
email.
say I missed you guys.
We missed you, Dor. All right. This is from dun, 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 Craig. First, I really enjoy the podcast network. I started with Linux for the rest of us and have expanded from there. In Android App Addicts, episode number 56, an emailer asked about a program to lock out certain programs for the kids. Kid Mode by Zoodles is what I
Ooh.
use for locking up the tablet when I give it to the kid. Kid Mode by Zoodles. It comes with some programs, allows you to add only the programs you want kids to access, and gives the ability to keep the kids off the internet. Thanks for the great shows from Craig. Zoodles. Check it out. Have you guys heard of that?
I didn't know it actually locked the phone out.
Sure.
I've never heard of it, but if I can add to that, my UI, I believe there are settings. I'm looking real quick where I think you can certain applications where you can password them. So
Yeah, if
basically
you
kind of
do,
do that.
yeah, I know if you do privacy mode, it will do a hard lockdown, and I think there is a middle ground lockdown, like you're saying.
Yeah, where you can kind of, you have to have the password to run that application.
Looks like my UI for the win, all across the board. And thank you, Craig. for sending that email. If I hear one more thing about MyUI, I'm going to have to actually install it. All right. Next one is from, looks like another one from Craig. Hey, guys, have you ever needed, this might be a different Craig, I'm not sure. Hey, guys, have you ever needed to undo some big mistake on your Android device? I wanted to after about the first week, but could not find a way to do it. After you mentioned about different keyboards on a recent episode on Android App Addicts, I started looking into them, and I came across AI Type. This app includes an undo. I could not believe it. My question is, what do you use for undo, or don't you make mistakes? Thanks for the great show, Craig in Indiana. The question is, what do you use for undo? Oh, what do we use for undo? I don't undo anything. You guys?
I just suffer and roll on.
That's exactly what I do.
Yeah.
So, did he say he found one? Oh, AI Type. This app includes an undo. Okay, so he found AI Type. Sorry, Craig, for botching the email a little bit. But that's the only thing I've ever heard of that had undo. Any input on this, guys?
Sounds like a really good feature.
AI Type. Is it a keyboard?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's a keyboard. The only thing I don't see on it is a microphone button.
Sometimes on my better keyboard, I don't get the microphone button. I don't know why.
Yeah, it does matter. Oh, there you go. See, you can undo, redo, select, ABC, select all, the arrow keys, back a word, forward a word, cut, copy, paste, home, end, backspace, and read, which is the microphone button in inverse. You hit that, and it reads it back to you, I guess.
Huh. That's pretty cool. Well, thank you, Craig. AI Type. Check it out.
There's the mic button. I see it.
This is from Matt. He says, greetings. Just wanted to let you guys know about an app called Power Amp. If you don't have it already, it's the best music player available for Android. Great EQ, organization, and has a wide range of features. I'm impressed. Also, I've just rooted my Motorola Photon 4G and installed an app called ROM Toolbox from the market. It combines features from many apps like Titanium Backup and Set CPU, and overall has the widest range of features and tweaks of any customization app I've seen. You can change the system font and the boot animation, free system apps, and so much more, all on a simple and easy-to-use interface. It's also integrated with ROM Manager to make it easier to create backups and flash custom ROMs, although my phone is not yet supported by ROM Manager. Please check these two apps out and let me know what you think. The world deserves to know about them. Peace out, baby. That's from Matt.
Yeah,
thanks, Matt. Well, first, I'm jealous you have a Photon. Go ahead.
Yeah. This audio app, I believe, was the audio app brought up by our friend Eric Sauce, because the big knobs look familiar.
Oh, we did Power Amp before?
I think Eric brought it up. He might not have brought it up as a official app. He might have just mentioned it on the show.
I got to look at it, because I would recognize the knobs.
Yeah, I'll say if you have even semi-quality headphones or you are pushing it out to an actual stereo system, this is the only audio player I know with these kind of settings with a real EQ built in.
Yeah, they're definitely, some music players have killer EQs. Some of them are lacking, and EQs can make all the difference, especially on Android phones, because on some of them, you don't know what you're getting out of there, and you just have to totally tweak the sound. Sweet. Well, thank you, Matt. All right, do you guys have anything else before we end off the show?
I use ROM Toolbox, but it isn't really supported on my device, so I can really only use it in a couple little areas. It's one of those things I really would like to use it.
Yeah, it looks pretty awesome.
Yeah. Well, it looks like it's really simple. You just, boom, load the app, and if you pay for it, you have more ROMs to pick from, and you just pick, oh, there's some ROMs, let me browse. Oh, download ROM, hit it, boom, it downloads a ROM. Oh, install ROM. Oh, while you're at it, make a backup, boom, and it does it for you. It really holds your hand through the ROMing process.
Really? That's awesome.
Yeah.
Hey, have you guys seen, what do you think about the Tegra 3?
Oh,
the first device is going to be the Asus Transformer.
I've got my eye on that Prime.
Yeah. You do, Tim?
Yes, I do.
Yeah, that thing's supposed to be, I think on another podcast I heard, they said it has an extra like four cores plus a fifth one?
It has a fifth one. It has a fifth one that's a low megahertz core.
Right.
Where when it's doing mundane tasks, it uses that core, and the other cores are basically shut off. This is how you can get, technically speaking, a much more powerful processor, yet you still get longer battery life.
Yeah.
Oh.
Big time battery life. You're saying 12 hours on that.
I know. It's killer. Anything else? Any other news on devices, whatnot? I'll wait for Door to finish that beer.
Sorry. I was going to say, they're just going ballistic. They really are.
Who is?
If you're everybody, it seems like Verizon, I know, is a little crazy here in the next month. They're getting some really hot devices.